Just you write down next point. I'll draw the structure. You will understand this. Write down next line. Nucleosides are N-glycosides of purine. Nucleosides are N-glycosides sites of purine or pyrimidine bases with pentose sugar. So this is the definition of nucleoside, pentose sugar. What are nucleosides? We have a pentose sugar, and that is linked with purine or pyrimidine base with N-glycosidic linkage. Okay. So what do you mean by this N-glycosidic linkage? Suppose if I draw the structure of sugar here, which is this. This is a structure of sugar. I won't draw the entire thing here. Right, so we have all these bonds present. OH, H, you can put it on here. CH2OH like this we have here. And this carbon, this C1, actually, it is attached with the base like this. Nitrogen, and then the ring we have like this. Okay. Write down here base and base. So this link is what? This link is the N-glycosidic bond. N-glycosidic bond. So these are nucleosides actually. So when you take adenine as a base, the nucleoside is adenosine. So with base, what is the name of nucleoside we have? I'll write down here. Base one side, and the name of nucleoside this side. So if the base is adenine, nucleoside is adenosine. If the base is guanine, nucleoside is guanosine. Cytosine. It's cytidine. Thymidine. Uracil. It is uridine. So the point is, this reference compound is pentose only. This is not going to change. But base can be changed. If the base is this, corresponding nucleoside is this, the name I have written. Similarly, nucleotides are what? The last thing here we discuss is nucleotides. Okay, a structure of DNA is a double helix structure that you can go through. Okay, structure of DNA, Okay, so this is nucleosides, you should know. Next we'll discuss is, all of you have written this?
Yeah.
Okay. Similarly, nucleosides, like I discussed, it is the combination of purine or pyrimidine base with pentose sugar. And this base and sugar is connected with N-glycosidic linkage. Nucleosides is this. Similarly, nucleotides also we can define. Okay, so what is nucleotide? Write down. Nucleotide is a phosphate ester of nucleosides. A nucleotide is a phosphate ester of nucleoside which contains a purine or pyrimidine base. Okay. Which contains a purine or pyrimidine base with 5, write it like this, purine and pyrimidine base with a sugar, with a sugar contains 5 carbon atoms. Okay. One thing I'll repeat here in the last page, that this structure is a base. It is not the actual structure. I have just drawn this to make you understand what is N-glycosidic bond. Suppose adenine base you are taking. So here we have the structure of adenine. Guanine, then the structure of guanine. So this is just a base where this N bond is joined with this carbon. So it is not any, correct structure is this. It is not the correct structure because we have 2 nitrogen present in the ring, all these if you see. That's what the meaning of this. Anyways, so next thing is what? This nucleotides, like I said, it has one base, right? Purine or pyrimidine base plus 5-membered sugar plus phosphate. And then it forms nucleotide, okay? If I draw the structure here of a nucleotide, the structure will be like this. Okay. C1 carbon, we have hydrogen here. And this contains one, like I said, one base. So this is the base I am using here. Double bond O. Here we have double bond. Here we have double bond. And here we have NH2. So this is one base we have connected with C1. OH, H, this is the sugar we have, pentose. So OH, H, and here we have H, CH2. OH we have in general, but it is connected with a phosphate. Okay, so this point, it is linked with a phosphate ion, which is P double bond O, O minus, single bond O minus. So phosphate, sugar, 5-membered ring, and a base. This thing is nucleotides. Okay. So base is there. This one is sugar. And this one is phosphate. They won't ask you the structure. You should know the definitions of nucleotides. However, this is also not that much important. Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
One note you write down. Nucleotides are linked together. Nucleotides are linked together by phosphodiester linkage. Phosphodiester linkage between 5th and 3rd carbon atom of pentose sugar. Okay, this is the last thing you have to keep in mind. A structure also you can draw two phosphate group you have to attach at fifth and third carbon, okay, on pentose sugar. Like you see, here we have this group attached here. Okay. One more if you attach this side, okay, this gives you phosphodiester linkage. Here, the same, this group present at this carbon, third carbon. This is third and this is fifth carbon. So this is the, you know, way the nucleotides are linked together. This is one nucleotide molecule. At this point, the another nucleotides are linked. Okay. So like that, you'll get a very, you know, big complex structure. NCRT, I don't know whether it is given or not, this structure. But all these things you don't have to draw. You should know the key points that I have given you, that nucleotides are linked together by phosphodiester linkage. This term is important, phosphodiester linkage between third and fifth carbon. Okay, so this is it. After this, we have function of DNA and RNA, which is not required, but I'll suggest you to go through once through NCRT. That is more than enough. Okay.
Yes, sir.
This is done. Nothing is there. Okay. So what we do next? We have half an hour more. Tell me. Any doubt you have? What?
No doubt, sir.
Okay. One question you solve then. One last question. We will finish it early today. Not from this, some other things we'll see. Did you write the test yesterday? This KVPY test? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
One question was there. Let me give you that question. Wait.
So there was this one question as to Friedel-Crafts alkylation, what it means.
What?
It said there was this question in that test. It said Friedel-Crafts alkylation is, and then four options. What are aromatic nucleus and olefin?
Do you have that question now?
1 minute, I'll try pulling it.
You have your phone with you right now, all of you? Okay, let it be. I'll write down the question here. See, the question is 2.52 gram of hydrated oxalic acid is oxalic acid with 2H2O. Hydrated oxalic acid was dissolved in 100 ml of water. 100 ml of H2O. 10 ml of this solution. 10 ml of this solution was diluted to 500 ml. Find normality of the final solution. Normality and the amount of oxalic acid oxalic acid present in the final solution. Do this. What is the answer you got, Shreya?
That 0.08 thing.
Did you get the option right?
Yeah.
How? Do it now. Shreya, the question is there.
It was dehydrated, not hydrated.
The question is there, dehydrated. Okay. But with dehydrated, it means the molecular mass should be what?
63.
It should be 19, right? Dehydrated means what? I have given here hydrated oxalic acid. Okay. I did not check this because the solution was given over there, no? Their solution, the molecular mass they have taken as 126, correct?
Yeah.
126. But in the question, they have given dehydrated. So when it's dehydrated, it means the mass, molecular mass should be what? 90?
Oh, I switched both, sir, by mistake. That's so why I was getting the answer.
Yeah, so when you get this dehydrated oxalic acid, if you take, okay, then the answer will be something else. It is not there in the option. Okay. Answer is something else which is not given in the option. So you try this. Hydrated means molecular mass is this. Number of equivalents will be what? Mass divided by equivalent mass, 2.52 divided by equivalent mass E. So equivalent mass of oxalic acid is what? If it is hydrated, I am going through the options, so through the solution which is given. Okay, taking this as hydrated. 2.52 divided by 126 divided by 2, N factor is 2 for oxalic acid. Okay, this you will get this by 63, that will be 0.04. Yes or no?
No, correct. Sir, it's 0.08 only.
So number of equivalents will be what? 0.04 divided by 100 ml into 1000. That will be 0.4. Now we use N1V1 is equals to N2V2. So N1V1 is 0.4 into volume is what? 10 ml of this solution is diluted. No, so into 10, N2 into volume is 500. So when you solve this N2, you'll get 0.008, which is not there in the option. Okay.
Yeah, but I thought it'd be the closest, like this 0.8, so that's why I marked that.
Fine, no issue. So this is a normality you'll get, and this normality, when you try to find out the mass is equals to equivalent by volume of solution is 500 into 1000. So number of equivalents you'll get here is around 0.004. which is mass by equivalent mass of oxalic acid, 63. And this is coming to be around 0.252 gram, which is not there in the option. Okay, so this we get when you are taking molecular mass is 26. And for this, the question should be hydrated oxalic acid. This is one thing. Correct. If it is dehydrated, then molecular mass is what, 90? Okay. So this will get here what for dehydrated, if you try to do, then the number of equivalents is what? Number of equivalents is 2.52 given mass divided by the equivalent mass. And that will be 2.52 divided by 90 divided by 2. What is this value? Tell me.
0.056
you are getting. Okay. So normality is what? 0.056 divided by volume is 100 into 1000. This will be 0.56 normal, correct? Now 0.56 into 10 is equals to 500 into n. So N2 is what? 0.56 into 10 divided by 500. What is this value?
0.011.
Which is again not there in the option. Right? I don't think 0.011 is there in the option. Is it?
No.
So that's why the answer was wrong. Okay, I think the when you look at the data, it should be hydrated oxalic acid. Then you see this equivalent weight is getting cancelled and we are getting proper 0.04 equivalent here. 63, 252/63, they're getting points. So it should be hydrated oxalic acid. Tell me anything else? Anything else?
No, sir.
Chalo, then we'll wind up, okay?